afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Live at 4 on this Thursday. Charlotte is back. Feeling better?
Much better. That's just good. Needed to get some rest.
Yeah, we all do every once in a while. It's good to have you back. We've got a busy show today. Harvey Briggs will be along later, so let's get right to it. Here's what's making news on this Thursday. Shots, shots, and more shots. Rock County is the latest to hold a vaccine day. Our Adam Dexter is live at the Edgerton High School to give us the latest.
And a ceasefire has been announced between Hamas and Israel. It is a halt in the fighting after 11 straight days of violence.
And President Biden signed the COVID hate crimes bill into law this afternoon. Let's take a look outside. This is the place to be today.
Oh, gosh.
It is warm and sticky. The humidity, it's too early for this, Austin.
Yeah, I would have to agree with that. It is a little bit too early for this. Average high temperature today, only 71 degrees. Right here in Madison, it's 80 degrees. We're about 10 degrees above average, and we're going to stay above average here for quite some time before we do cool things back down. After the next cool down that we're looking at, we're only going to be right around average again. So above average or average temperatures, it's exactly what we're dealing with over these next 7 to 10 days. Doppler track also looking pretty good. We actually have a lot of blue skies overhead in the Madison area right now. We're still expecting quite a bit of some cloud cover to end up filing on through, but for right now, the sunshine that we're seeing, I'm soaking it in while I personally can. Now, our Doppler track out west still showing a few more of those rain showers. We do still have that chance for a passing shower or even an isolated storm, but thankfully our severe risk for today has dropped down to pretty much near nothing. Now our temperatures, again, we're seeing those lower 80s. It's starting to warm up outside. Not only that, the dew points are rising, so it does feel like it's a pretty muggy day overall. Now to plan your evening out, we're looking at about 78 degrees here by 6 p.m. Notice how even by around 10 p.m. we're still going to be in those lower 70s, so these temperatures really aren't going to budge too much overall yet again here for tonight. And you can see that over these next 12 hours, staying very, very warm. Later on tonight, we only have a low of about 65 degrees. Lots of cloud cover, mild conditions, patchy fog, and an isolated shower or storm in the overnight hours tonight.
All right, we'll check back in a few minutes. Austin, thank you. Well, we know Dane County is one of the best in the country for vaccination rates. Just outside its borders, it's a different story.
Some counties trail Dane's first vaccine rate by a very wide margin, but Rock County health leaders, well, they're motivated to catch up. Adam Dexter joins us live from Edgerton High School, where the push toward boosting numbers is happening today. Adam?
Today, Rock County was almost a full 20 percentage points behind Dean County's 65% vaccination rate for those first doses. And just about 2,000 people aged 12 to 18 in Rock County had gotten their first dose of the shot. But starting today in Edgerton and continuing next week in Orfordville and Clinton, clinics at high schools hope to change that. And today's clinic at Edgerton goes until 5 p.m. and is open to students, but also anyone in the community on a drop-in basis. They've got enough for 300 plus first doses of the Pfizer vaccine.
Getting back to that normalcy is what I'm really craving for at this point. So our kids can have the experience that they want to have. Very age-specific experience. They can't get it back. They can't come back to high school when they're 25.
Adam tells, go ahead.
Okay, currently Rock County has at least 44% of the population that's gotten at least one shot, which is a considerable gap from what doctors and other experts would consider herd immunity. Tonight on News 3 Now at 5, Adam asks health leaders in Rock County if they think that's a possibility at this point, and we will hear from a sophomore who's ready to get her high school experience back. In the past 24 hours, nearly 22,000 Wisconsinites received a vaccine. This comes as more than 400 new cases of COVID was reported. And as vaccination efforts continue, 40% of Wisconsinites have now completed their vaccination series. 46% of residents have had at least one shot, and that is over 2.6 million people. In Dane County, nearly 300,000 residents have completed the vaccine series. 64% of residents have had one shot. Nearly 30% of 12 to 15-year-olds have had at least one shot. And almost 95% of residents 65 years and older have had at least one dose.
First Lady Dr. Jill Biden and the nation's top infectious disease expert, Dr. Anthony Fauci, toured a vaccination center in the nation's capital as states push ahead with plans to return to pre-pandemic life. Michael George reports from New York.
First Lady Dr. Jill Biden and Dr. Anthony Fauci made a stop at D.C.'s Children's National Hospital, emphasizing the need to vaccinate more Americans.
We're here to do vaccinations. We have hope. Look at all the people that have come.
Nationwide, new COVID cases have fallen below 30,000 a day for the first time in nearly a year. But cases in children are on the rise.
By the end of this calendar year, it's likely that we'll have enough information to vaccinate children of any age.
Just this week, the FDA eased cold storage rules for Pfizer's two-dose vaccine in an effort to make it more widely available. Here in New York, masks are no longer required in most settings for people who are fully vaccinated. And to reach those who aren't, the state will begin offering a lottery incentive starting next week.
Vaccine scratch. You get a vaccination, and you get a lottery ticket for the $5 million mega multiplier New York State lottery.
On Capitol Hill, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi says masks must stay on in the chamber and at hearings until more members are vaccinated.
They are selfishly a danger to other people, including staff people here.
She doesn't want to abide by the CDC rules. She actually wants to have greater control.
To deal with confusion over the CDC's mask guidance, the state of Oregon has taken the unprecedented step of requiring businesses to verify the vaccination status of all people who enter buildings without a mask. While in Iowa, Governor Kim Reynolds signed a law banning mask mandates in schools and businesses in the state. Michael George, CBS News, New York.
And Brown University is joining a growing number of colleges nationwide that will require employees and students to get COVID-19 vaccinations. The CEOs of Pfizer and Moderna now say the first Americans to be vaccinated against the coronavirus could require a third booster shot as early as September. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu's office has announced a ceasefire to halt an 11-day military operation against Hamas militants in the Gaza Strip. A statement issued late this afternoon said his security cabinet unilaterally approved an Egyptian-mediated proposal. This comes as Israel launched more airstrikes on Gaza City. Early today, families were again hit in the attacks. Hamas also fired rockets at Israel. The ceasefire decision came after heavy U.S. pressure to halt the offense. The offensive, that is. Israel authorities put the death toll to date at 12 in Israel in rocket attacks that have caused panic and sent people rushing into shelters.
Over 4,000 rockets have been fired by the Hamas into Israel. The Israeli National Police are continuing to respond to those rockets that are landing inside cities. Ashkelon, Ashdod, hundreds of rockets have landed. And at the moment, just behind me is a small quantity of those many rockets that have landed. And heightened security is continuing in the area as we speak right now.
It was not immediately clear when the truce was to take effect, but multiple reports say it would go into effect at 2 a.m. There was no immediate reaction from Hamas.
President Biden signed legislation this afternoon that aims to combat the spike in hate crimes against Asian Americans during the coronavirus pandemic. Biden, with Vice President Kamala Harris at his side, who is the first Asian American vice president, emphasized the bipartisan nature of this measure and insisted that hate can have no more place in America. The House passed the bill earlier this week by a vote of 364 to 62 after the Senate passed the measure 94 to 1.
Every time we're silent, every time we let hate flourish, we make a lie of who we are as a nation. I mean it literally. We cannot let the very foundation of this country continue to be eaten away like it has been in other moments in our history and happening again.
This bill brings us one step closer to stopping hate, not only for Asian Americans, but for all Americans.
The bill directs the Justice Department to speed up review of hate crime incidents and help state and local governments report hate crimes.
The House has narrowly approved $1.9 billion to fortify the Capitol after the January 6th insurrection. Democrats pushed past opposition from Republicans to provide emergency funding to harden the complex with retractable fencing, a quick response force, and police training. The legislation passed by only one vote, with several Democrats also opposing the measure.
The only recovery school in Dane County expanded its facilities today. Horizon High School educates teens in recovery from alcohol, drugs, and mental health. The school previously only had one bathroom, one classroom, and one office. The new facility houses four bathrooms, two classrooms, three offices, a kitchen, a laundry room, and an art space.
What we do is much different. We save lives. I mean, these kids come really broken to us, and they're young, and they're lost, and they're depressed, and they're addicted to drugs or alcohol or both, and mental health is through the roof. So we're kind of a 24/7 school, more like a family.
The local construction company, C.G. Schmidt, donated a large sum in order to make this facility a reality, and the Horizon staff said they were very grateful.
Republicans who control the Wisconsin Legislature's Budget Committee voted to reject more than $70 million in funding to combat homelessness, a move that Democrats called a missed opportunity to address a problem that worsened due to the pandemic. Governor Tony Evers had proposed spending around $73 million over 2 years on a variety of initiatives designed to help homeless people, including more affordable housing.
The mayor had her weekly briefing earlier today, and the main subject was something other than COVID and masks. Her newest issue is speeding. The movement is called 20 is Plenty, and its intent is to slow people down on residential streets. It is being tested in two districts before being considered citywide. This is being done to prioritize pedestrians and bikes and to make people safer in their own neighborhoods.
The data are so clear on the danger of speeding in our neighborhoods that I really ask you to watch your speed, go slowly, particularly in our neighborhood streets, and protect our friends and family and neighbors.
20 is Plenty is part of the Vision Zero initiative, which aims to eliminate traffic deaths and severe injuries by 2030. And we are learning today of the death of former UW basketball coach and tennis great John Paulus.
Paulus was UW's coach from 1969 to 1976. He later turned to coaching tennis and became a top-ranked senior tennis player around the world. Susan Simon and I sat down with John 6 years ago at the Paulus Tennis Center on Madison's West Side.
And your stamina is incredible. What do you eat, or what can we all go?
Well, go back to insanity first, Susan. I mean, I always say that you have to delight in punishing yourself mentally and physically to survive, but you have to develop a routine for your own game and for you as well. And I have mine where I've got to hit tennis balls every day.
Every day.
And there's a certain regimentation and there's a certain routine that's good for me, and that's what I try to do.
What is it about tennis that so touches you?
I say from the sororal, fraternal part of this thing, the friendship is, I've coached NCAA championship basketball teams and I have 20 years of it, but tennis people, I hear from multi-tennis people every day of my life. It doesn't matter, and there's a special thing about it. If somebody's not well, they'll get multi-phone calls and now emails and texts.
It's
and
a community.
So on. Really?
Can you imagine not playing tennis?
I really can't. I really can't imagine that. It's a fix. It's sort of like if I don't play, it's just a miserable day mentally and physically for me. But being able to get on a tennis court and to play, it makes up for a lot of deficiencies.
He was one of the good ones. John Paulus died after a long illness. He was 88 years old.
Certain HPV-related cancers?
You're not welcome here.
Get out of my face.
HPV can cause certain cancers when your child grows up. Get in its way. HPV can affect males and females, and there's no way to predict who will or won't clear the virus. The CDC recommends HPV vaccination at age 11 or 12 to help protect against certain cancers.
Hey, cancer, not my child.
Don't wait. Talk to your child's doctor about HPV vaccination today.
3 days only. Save an extra $700 on top appliance brands at Grand Appliances pre-Memorial Day sale. Get the guaranteed lowest prices on hundreds of in-stock appliances, including great deals like this Samsung front-load washer with steam for just $6.98 or this 25-cubic-foot LG French door refrigerator for just $14.98. Visit your local Grand showroom or grandappliance.com to save today. Grand Appliance. You make it home. We make it grand.
Chevy is America's fastest growing full-line brand, and people are taking it everywhere. Taking Trailblazer outdoors, confidently taking on new places with Equinox, and taking on more with Silverado. Whatever you do, there's a perfect Chevy to take you anywhere. Find your perfect Chevy and get up to 18% of MSRP cash back on select 2021 models. That's over $4,700 cash back on this Equinox. Chevrolet, the number one selling brand in Wisconsin.
Advanced non-small cell lung cancer can change everything, but your first treatment could be a chemo-free combination of two immunotherapies that works differently. It could mean a chance to live longer. Opdivo plus Yervoy is for adults newly diagnosed with non-small cell lung cancer that has spread, test positive for PD-L1, and does not have an abnormal EGFR or ALK gene. It is the only FDA-approved combination of two immunotherapies. Opdivo plus Yervoy equals a chance for more starry nights, more sparkly days, more sunny mornings. Opdivo and Yervoy can cause your immune system to harm healthy parts of your body during and after treatment. These problems can be severe and lead to death. See your doctor right away if you have a cough, chest pain, shortness of breath, irregular heartbeat, diarrhea, constipation, severe stomach pain, nausea or vomiting, dizziness, fainting, eye problems, extreme tiredness, changes in appetite, thirst or urine, rash, itching, confusion, memory problems, muscle pain or weakness, joint pain, flushing or fever. These are not all the possible side effects. Problems can occur together and more often when Opdivo is used with Yervoy. Tell your doctor about all medical conditions, including immune or nervous system problems, if you've had or plan to have an organ or stem cell transplant or received chest radiation. Here's to a chance to live longer. Ask your doctor about chemo-free Opdivo plus Yervoy. Thank you to all those in our clinical trials.
Is your credit score getting in the way of the things you want to do? Personal loans through NetCredit offer fast and flexible lending. Borrow up to $10,000 and choose repayment terms that work for you. You may even be able to build your credit history as you repay. NetCredit, a more personal loan.
Panda lovers in Washington, D.C. will finally get their first look in nearly a year at the nation's beloved giant pandas as the Smithsonian National Zoo reopens tomorrow, concluding its second closure of the COVID-19 pandemic.
A limited number of journalists were allowed into the zoo today to preview the popular giant panda habitat, where father Tian Tian and mother Mei Xiong frolic with their cub, Xiao Qi Ji. Mei Xiong and Xiao Qi Ji were mostly in view, seen chewing contentedly on bamboo.
Our pandas are, you know, they do two things extremely well. They love to eat and they love to sleep. And they get great care here. And so they haven't missed a beat.
The zoo's giant pandas have long been a main attraction, but panda lovers might want to get to the zoo sooner than later to catch them in action. The zoo says the shy animals will choose to spend more time indoors during the coming summer heat.
Well, now that masks are coming off, sales of something else have jumped. A makeup staple that was ditched during the pandemic is making a big comeback. Lipstick, of course, up more than 80% from last year as more people get vaccinated and the pace of social interactions picks up. It's becoming a standout performer in all segments of cosmetics. Stocks snapped a three-day losing streak after jobless claims hit new lows. The Dow Industrials added 188 points, closing at 34,084. The NASDAQ was up 236, and the S&P 500 gained 43.
Memorial Day weekend is almost here, and the start of summer is right behind it. All that means is backyard barbecue season.
If you're in the market for a new grill, you're in luck. Earlier today, I talked with Consumer Reports home and appliance reporter and grilling expert, Paul Hope. Okay. Let's talk about grills. There are so many different types. Is one better than the other?
Well, you know, that's totally right. There are a bunch of different types that you're going to find now, and there really is no best type of grill. The real answer to that question is you have to consider what you're going to cook, who you're going to cook for. So one obvious choice is a gas grill that remains the best seller and probably the thing you're going to see the most of at home centers and hardware stores. At Consumer Reports, we like gas grills because we think they're sort of a great entry point into the grill world. You can control them pretty readily. They light quickly. And they typically cook at a broad range of temperatures, which makes them really well suited for, you know, everything from a delicate piece of fish all the way up to a steak or grilled veggies, obviously.
Does Consumer Reports recommend a particular one?
Absolutely. So, you know, a lot of grills do well in our ratings. One line that consistently performs well is the Weber Genesis line. The Weber Genesis E310 in particular is a really nice blend of just sort of stellar performance and great features. And as a brand, Weber has done very well traditionally in our reliability surveys as well, meaning they last quite a long time.
I see a good old-fashioned Weber kettle grill behind you. What's the benefit of charcoal?
You do. So, you know, there are two styles of charcoal grills. I have a Weber kettle behind me, and people who love love grilled food and love the taste of charcoal, say there's nothing like it. I tend to be one of those people who agrees, you know, charcoal really imparts a great smoky flavor to a lot of food. Particularly if you also add wood chips or wood chunks during the cooking process. That makes it a great option for things like steak, lamb chops, sort of hearty foods that stand up well to some of that heavier smoke. Might be overpowering for certain foods, but if you like the taste, it's really the way to go.
And then there's the Kamado grills and pellet grills and all sorts of different kinds.
Absolutely. So Kamado grills are really a sort of big step up from a regular charcoal grill. They burn charcoal just like the little kettle grill behind me, but they hold a lot of it, up to 5 pounds. And what that does is it lets you cook for a really long time or at really high temperatures. So Kamado grills in our tests get as hot as 1,000 degrees, which is, you know, incredible for something like making a wood-fired pizza or really searing a steak without overcooking it in the middle. But you can also restrict the airflow and dial it back, and Kamados can be set up to smoke brisket or baby back ribs all day at low temperatures in the 200-degree range.
And pellet grills, the same thing?
Absolutely. So pellet grills are a really interesting sort of newcomer to the market, at least at home centers this year. They use wood pellets made from the same wood species that you might smoke or barbecue with, like pecan or oak or hickory. And they make these little compressed sawdust pellets that provide the fuel and the heat source for the grill. So you actually plug the grill in. It's got an electronically controlled hopper, and the pellet grills will actually draw pellets from a hopper and burn them for heat and cook automatically at a preset temperature. So you really never have to worry about it. You rarely have to check on a pellet grill, and it's a great option. That said, they're not as hot always as other grills, so they're not always the best option for searing.
Now, before we let you go, do you have a recipe you can share with us for the grill?
Absolutely. So we have a wonderful recipe from Chef Katie Button in Asheville, North Carolina. She was gracious enough to share with us her recipe for spice-rubbed hanger steak, which is something that works well on just about any type of grill.
And we'll have that online for everyone to copy and grill this Memorial Day weekend. Paul, thanks for being with us today. Happy grilling.
Thanks, you too.
All right, gas or charcoal, Charlotte?
Oh, we have a gas at home.
Yeah.
But I know people who love their charcoal. I just don't have the patience.
I know. If you want to make something quick after work.
Mm-hmm.
I had charcoal forever, and I got talked
and
into
then you
gas.
Switched.
I got talked into it, so.
Whatever, just barbecue. Doesn't
just barbecue,
matter,
right? Whatever it is.
That's the goal.
Get out there.
All right, we'll be right back.
Tonight on CBS, it's a night of comedy and drama, beginning with Young Sheldon, followed by United States of Al, plus Mom, Be Positive, and the thriller Clarice. Then get a complete wrap-up of the day's news on News 3 Now at 10. The Memorial Day appliance deals start now at Furniture and Appliance Mart. Save huge during the biggest sale of the season, including in-stock doorbusters up to 40% off, plus no interest financing for 18 months. At Furniture and Appliance Mart, inside Ashley Home Store off the Beltline.
Erectile dysfunction for men of all ages has become much more common. In fact, most men don't realize that 90% of erectile dysfunction is a direct result of broken down old blood vessels. This causes a lack of blood flow that is critical when achieving an erection. With our state-of-the-art technology, we're able to stimulate new stem cell growth right in our office with no pills, no needles, no surgery, and no pain.
To book your consultation and get back to natural functionability, call Peak Performance for Men today.
Chevy is America's fastest-growing full-line brand, and people are taking it everywhere. Taking Trailblazer outdoors, confidently taking on new places with Equinox, and taking on more with Silverado. Whatever you do, there's a perfect Chevy to take you anywhere. Find your perfect Chevy and get up to 18% of MSRP cash back on select 2021 Chevy SUV models, or get a $4,000 cash allowance on all 2021 Silverado 1500 True Cab pickups.
I felt gross.
It was kind of a shock after I started Cosentyx.
4 years clear.
Real people with psoriasis look and feel better with Cosentyx.
Don't use if you're allergic to Cosentyx. Before starting, get checked for tuberculosis. An increased risk of infections and lowered ability to fight them may occur. Tell your doctor about an infection or symptoms. If your inflammatory bowel disease symptoms develop or worsen, or if you've had a vaccine or plan to, serious allergic reactions may occur. Learn more at Cosentyx.com.
We made USAA insurance for members like Martin, an Air Force veteran made of doing what's right, not what's easy. So when a hailstorm hit, USAA reached out before he could even inspect the damage.
That's how you do it right.
USAA insurance is made just the way Martin's family needs it. With hassle-free claims, he got paid before his neighbor even got started. Because doing right by our members, that's what's right. USAA. What you're made of, we're made for. USAA.
The biggest sale of the season starts now. It's the Memorial Day sale at Ashley Home Store. Shop in-stock doorbusters up to 60% off while they last. Plus, take a bonus 10% off our furniture sale prices. And no interest financing for 5 years. Ashley Home Store.
Take a look at this. Residents of the Russian city, southern city of Astronik, Ken, were fazed by a giant sandstorm hitting the area. In just a few minutes, the usually green area around the city started looking like a Mars landscape. Local health ministry officials reported that at least two people were injured by strong winds. According to the weather forecast, it'll stay extremely warm and dry in the area for the next 10 days with sudden wind rushes.
Wow.
Didn't see that coming.
No.
Well, everybody talks about cicadas. One man decides to use them in his cooking. Talk about resourceful.
That's one way to say
it. Disgusting.
Disgusting would be more like it. This man is Chef Tobias Padovano, and he will pick them up anywhere from trees, off his house. It doesn't matter where they come from because they're going to all end up in the same place, at the bottom of a pan. He then sells them in his restaurant in Leesburg, Virginia. First, oh my gosh, he sautés the cicadas with serrano chilies, onions, and garlic. That's a really good base. Then combines avocado and radish in a mole verde sauce, all wrapped up in a flour tortilla. And that is how you make a cicada taco. Bon appetit.
This is the time to come out and try them. They only come around so often. And if you're an adventurous eater the way I am, it's a great time. It really is. It's a great time to come out and eat some really good food.
Entomologists say being eaten by animals like birds, dogs, and even humans is crucial to the cicada's survival as a species because they emerge in such huge numbers. Many more will survive than could ever end up in tacos.
Pass.
Yeah, hard pass. No. Austin, you go.
Yeah, I'm going to have to take a hard pass on that as well. I mean, the recipe sounds good.
It does.
Maybe take out the cicadas.
Mm-hmm.
They're just so hideous.
Cicada-free taco. Yeah. How's that?
I'll take that. They do not look like pretty animals, unfortunately.
Tastes like crickets.
Yeah. Ugh. Never tried either of them. Don't plan on it either, personally. But I am planning on spending some time outdoors because, I mean, take a look at it right now. We are looking good to go. Nice, beautiful shot of some of the flowers. Here's a look outdoors right now. Still quite a bit of some cloud cover, some sunshine peeking through. But how many rain chances do we have in this extended forecast? Find out right after the break.
Get more enjoyment from your outdoor space with patio enclosures. Right now, get up to $6,500 off your sunroom. Plus, no interest if paid in full in 24 months. Call today.
Patio Enclosures.
Right now, get $500 off stressless signature base recliners or recliners with classic power. And $200 off new motorized stressless Max and Mike recliners, the latest great innovation from Stressless. Plus, get $200 off each stressless Mary and Emily sofa seat. Celebrate 50 years of stressless comfort and save at the Century House, 3420 University Avenue in Madison.
Fire sprinklers. Fire sprinklers buy time. Time buys life. Learn more at firesprinklersbylife.com.
Hi, I'm Crystal the Pistol Gobin. Gobin Cars has over 500 vehicles in stock with 2017 and 2018 Jeep Grand Cherokee Altitudes and Limiteds with remaining factory warranty. That's right, Gobin Cars has over 500 vehicles in stock with great deals on our huge selection of Jeep Grand Cherokees. So hurry in today and get your great deal and ask for me, Crystal the Pistol Gobin. Go to Gobin Cars East or West.
You gotta go to Gobin, GobinCars.com.
Certain HPV-related cancers?
You're not welcome here.
Get out of my face.
HPV can cause certain cancers when your child grows up. Get in its way. HPV can affect males and females, and there's no way to predict who will or won't clear the virus. The CDC recommends HPV vaccination at age 11 or 12 to help protect against certain cancers.
Hey, cancer, not my child.
Don't wait. Talk to your child's doctor about HPV vaccination today.
Get more enjoyment from your outdoor space with patio enclosures. Right now, get up to $6,500 off your sunroom. Plus, no interest if paid in full in 24 months. Call today.
Patio Enclosures.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Welcome back. Now, taking a peek outside, it still feels pretty good, but it is warm out there and it's pretty muggy. You're going to start to see quite a few bugs flying around. You might want to make some tacos with it, but I don't think I will personally. Now, our shower chances will linger all the way through tomorrow. We are looking at some warm conditions, the 70s and 80s for pretty much this entire forecast. And we're even looking at a few days that could potentially bounce into the mid to even upper 80s. And then the humidity returns. We could actually feel that outdoors right now. Live look outside, still quite a bit of some cloud cover. We're not seeing completely cloud-free skies, but we are still seeing some sunshine poking through here and there. And our low temperatures this morning, this is where we started out, mid-60s. Tomorrow at this time, we're likely going to be right around those 80s, but in the morning hours, we're still going to see those 60s again, as it does stay on the warmer side of things. Now, our current temperatures, 80 degrees in Madison, 81 in Janesville. A lot of communities, especially out west, have gotten trapped in the upper 70s. Look at Viroqua right now. They're at 71 degrees. Not as warm as the rest of us, but we are looking at finally a change in this pattern. I've been showing this, and it has shown very consistently those above average temperatures. Now it's starting to show a little bit of a cool down towards the end of our forecast, but we are also looking at those average high temperatures in the lower 70s. So with the 80s that we're seeing today, we are still well above where we should be. 6 to 10 day precipitation outlook still showing a better than average chance to see some rain showers and hopefully some storms here as well. We do need that rainfall. I've said that for quite some time. I'll show you the drought monitor here in just a bit, but these rain chances are very, very necessary. Just about a 30% chance here for today. Most of the day staying dry. Much of the same for tomorrow. Most of the day staying dry, but then we bump up those chances over the weekend. In terms of what we're looking at here for our severe weather outlook, we're not going to see anything here today that is strong or severe. Tomorrow, on the other hand, this did just recently update. We could see a potential for a stronger, possibly even an isolated severe storm. So we're going to continue to watch out for that. Again, that risk lies tomorrow for most of us. Doppler track looking pretty good, but our future track still does show another chance for a spotty shower, possibility of a storm, especially in our western communities. By the time we reach tomorrow, especially in the afternoon and evening hours, this is what we're looking at for that potential for a stronger storm. We might see one or two of these cells actually popping up here quite a bit tomorrow. But in terms of our drought monitor, we are still in that moderate drought phase. This did just recently update, so we are looking at the latest and greatest. We need those rain showers. We might see one tonight with that low of about 65 degrees, but overall in your 7 to 10 day forecast, we can see those 80s sticking around and hanging around here for quite some time, all the way through this next Tuesday. After we cool things back down, we're going to see the 70s returning, and I'm circling currently Thursday. 72 degrees with quite a bit of sunshine. That's a perfect day for me.
Yeah, a little early for this.
It's a little bit early to be seeing the 80s and even upper 80s on Saturday.
I'm cool with that.
That's warm.
All right, Austin, thank you.
Well, after a record-breaking storm season in 2020, forecasters are expecting another active hurricane season this year.
Elise Preston has the latest from Coney Island.
The 2021 Atlantic hurricane season could be another busy one.
So we're really looking at some sort of
hurricane season in 2021 that probably will be above average again.
Forecasters at NOAA's Climate Prediction Center are expecting a range of 13 to 20 named storms with winds 39 miles per hour or higher. 6 to 10 of those storms could become hurricanes with winds over 74 miles per hour. And there's a chance for 3 to 5 major hurricanes that are Category 3, 4, or 5 with winds 111 miles per hour or higher.
The Atlantic hurricane season doesn't officially start until June, but forecasters warn a major storm before then is not out of the question.
6 years in a row, we've actually had systems develop before the hurricane season in the Atlantic. So it's one of these things that we're warmer. The oceans have been prime. Everything has really come together before the season.
Residents here along the New York coast are not too concerned about what's ahead.
Hurricane season doesn't bother us, I don't think, as much as it would other people, besides like Sandy that one time.
Weather experts say rising sea levels make coastal communities even more vulnerable when storms hit. Elise Preston, CBS News, Coney Island, New York.
While forecasters are expecting a busy storm season, they don't expect it to be as busy as last year's when 12 named storms made landfall in the U.S. Wisconsin Republicans are working on bills that would ban transgender athletes from playing on teams they identify with. But the Monona Grove School District is hoping to change the lawmakers' minds who back these bills. Our Jamie Perez is live at 5 with the latest.
You've been taking mental health meds, and your mind is finally in a better place. Except now, you have uncontrollable body movements called tardive dyskinesia, TD. And it can seem like that's all people see. Some meds for mental health can cause abnormal dopamine signaling in the brain. While how it works is not fully understood, Ingrezza is thought to reduce that signaling.
Ingrezza is a prescription medicine used to treat adults with TD movements in the face and body. People taking Ingrezza can stay on their current dose of most mental health meds. Don't take Ingrezza if you're allergic to any of its ingredients. Ingrezza may cause serious side effects, including sleepiness. Don't drive, operate heavy machinery, or do other dangerous activities until you know how Ingrezza affects you. Other serious side effects include potential heart rhythm problems and abnormal movements.
Shift the focus more on you. Ask your doctor about Ingrezza. It's simple. One pill, once daily. Number one prescribed for TD. Learn how you could pay as little as $0 at Ingrezza.com.
Step one, build a new breed. Make it an SUV. Send it off-road. Send it to Baja. Then evolve, enhance, expand. Make it capable, smart, human. And then make more. Because the only way to predict the future is to build it. And the only way to build it is Ford Proud. See your Ford dealer to build and pre-order a select SUV, like the new Bronco Sport, and get an additional $500 bonus certificate on top of all offers.
Some days, you just don't have it. Not my uncle, though. He's taking Trulicity for his type 2 diabetes. And now, he's really on his game.
Once weekly Trulicity lowers your A1C by helping your body release the insulin it's already making. Most people reached an A1C under 7%. Plus, Trulicity can lower your risk of cardiovascular events. It can also help you lose up to 10 pounds. Trulicity is for type 2 diabetes. It isn't for people with type 1 diabetes. It's not approved for use in children. Don't take Trulicity if you're allergic to it. You or your family have medullary thyroid cancer or have multiple endocrine neoplasia syndrome type 2. Stop Trulicity and call your doctor right away if you have an allergic reaction, a lump or swelling in your neck, severe stomach pain, changes in vision, or diabetic retinopathy. Serious side effects may include pancreatitis. Taking Trulicity with sulfonylurea or insulin raises low blood sugar risk. Side effects include nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea, which can lead to dehydration and may worsen kidney problems. Show your world what's truly inside. Ask your doctor about once weekly Trulicity.
Tonight at 5, the push to get children vaccinated, what Rock County is doing to make sure those 12 years and older are able to get their shots at 5.
And we're in a bit of a summery pattern with very mild temperatures, humid conditions, and a few showers and thunderstorms possible through the weekend into the start of next week. We'll take a closer look at your full forecast.
And ahead at 6, Monona Grove School District is working to prevent a Republican bill seeking to ban transgender athletes from playing on teams they identify with.
At downtown Madison on this kind of muggy day today. Some chances of rain coming, hopefully.
You should just lose the jacket. You'll feel
better. Where would I put my microphone?
Yeah, that's true. All right, so we are...
We were talking about that because we're outside.
Yes. We are sure that you're pretty familiar with the luxury auto brand Mercedes-Benz. But did you know that they have a sub-brand called AMG? I didn't know this. And they generally have higher trim levels and tons more power than their non-AMG stablemates.
It's a combination of power and luxury, which, of course, comes at a price. Let's find out if they hit the mark as we go behind the wheel with Harvey Briggs in the 2021 Mercedes AMG E53.
Reviving an old British tradition, I'm Ian Lee with why sales of this Victorian classic are surging.
Brilliant. Dismount. 6 feet away.
Penny farthing.
Okay.
Do we have the Mercedes? Not yet.
Should we just talk to Harvey about the Mercedes? Because I know nothing about the Mercedes or the AMG.
We're going to go to a spot and figure this out.
Okay. We're going to talk to Harvey.
Here we go.
Harvey, it's all on you now. I was asking you.
I think we're doing the package. Here's the Mercedes. Our first post-pandemic, mask-free, fully vaccinated
That's
car.
Right.
We might as well do it in style.
That's right. Let's do it with a Mercedes, and not just any Mercedes, but a Mercedes AMG. So this is, AMG is the high-performance tuning division for Mercedes-Benz, kind of like BMW has M and Lexus has F.
So it's basically an E-Class Mercedes sedan with more aggressive suspension and transmission and more direct steering feel. The front end is unique for the AMG line.
You have AMG-specific wheels and taillights as well on this.
It should be OMG.
It is OMG when you put your foot in it. This is 462 horsepower, Mark.
Wow. Plus, this Mercedes has a 48-volt electric hybrid system, which gives it 21 extra horsepower. That gives you a little boost to help this 4,500-pound sedan get moving. But wait, there's more.
They also have, for the turbocharger, an additional compressor that is electrically driven so that you don't have to wait for the turbocharger to spin up to get all that power.
It seems like a lot of stuff to go wrong.
It's, you know, German cars typically are complex.
It's time to find out what all those ponies can deliver. All right, we're all vaccinated. Mike included, the photographer. Let's go for a ride.
Let's do it. The really interesting thing about this is when you get it out on a back road and you go kind of have a little fun with it, it feels much smaller and lighter than it is, and which is a real achievement.
And it's fun to drive.
Yeah, you know, 462 horsepower, so you're 0 to 60 in 4.3 seconds. You know, it does have a top speed that will get you thrown in jail if you so choose to do that.
It's better to spend time in this Mercedes than the Huskow. Instead of steel bars, this is the lap of luxury and high tech.
This new, they call it M-Bucks, Mercedes-Benz user experience, and you have two 12.3-inch touchscreens.
One screen's devoted to regular dashboard stuff, the other for navigation, infotainment, and HVAC.
You've got this nice black ash wood. You've got leather dash with the hand stitching, leather-wrapped steering wheel. And, of course, in this model, you have these really deeply bucketed sports seats that provide a great amount of support when you're driving more spiritedly.
Harvey's also impressed by the voice command system. It's very intuitive, and you can use natural language instead of a series of commands.
Just go, "Hey, Mercedes.
How can I help?"
Lower the temperature to 68 degrees.
"I'm setting the temperature to 68 degrees.
Thank you. All of this technology, all of this luxury, all of this power and engineering comes, of course, at a price.
The E-Class starts at about $54,000 for the E350. This one starts at $72,000, and the way we have it equipped is $82,000.
It's a lot of money.
Yeah, it is a lot of money. There are so many cars in that price range now, and I'm just curious as to
Who's buying all these things?
Certainly not these two. Pull over. Okay. Look at the... And Harvey is here down on the patio with us. $82,000.
You know, that's what a luxury performance sedan with that kind of performance costs. And if you want it, whether you want a BMW, a Mercedes, or an Audi, that's what you're going to pay.
Now, you were talking about during the break that I was asking if it, you know, if it has a pizza oven or something in there, but it doesn't. But you said it does have some really impressive stuff.
Well, yeah, it's got, you know, all the performance that you want, but then you've got comfort features like really the seats actually move and shift on you so you don't get stuck in one place the whole time you're driving.
Yeah, they just sort of move around to keep you awake.
Right.
Okay.
And then it has an air purifier and an ionizer and a scent. So you can buy different scents to get
just what you want. Oh, my gosh, like a little aromatherapy.
Exactly.
Wow.
And red seat belts.
And red seat belts.
At no
extra charge. You get a performance car without red seat belts?
Read more at ridesanddrives.com. Harvey? Good to see you.
Great to see
fully
you.
Fully vaccinated
guys.
Here in the backyard.
Love it.
It's been a year and a
Thanks
half.
For here being
we are. We're getting close.
We're getting close. All right. We'll be right back.
With less moderate to severe eczema, why hide your skin? If you can help heal your skin from within. With Dupixent, adults saw long-lasting, clearer skin and significantly less itch. Don't use if you're allergic to Dupixent. Serious allergic reactions can occur, including anaphylaxis, which is severe. Tell your doctor about new or worsening eye problems, such as eye pain or vision changes or a parasitic infection. If you take asthma medicines, don't change or stop them without talking to your doctor. Talk to your doctor about Dupixent.
It used to be that when you were healthy, you didn't have to think about healthcare.
You didn't care which doctors invented which treatment.
But now, things are different.
Now when you or someone close to you is sick, that's all you care about.
A doctor with answers. A medical team you can trust.
That treats you like you're important.
UW Health. Remarkable medicine. Remarkable care.
Steinhoffel's Memorial Day sale, and now is the best time to save big on your new Tempur-Pedic mattress. Queen Adapt mattresses start at only $19.99. Plus, save up to $500 on Tempur-Pedic adjustable base sets and get $300 in Steinhoffel's cash. Make your new mattress more affordable with Steinhoffel's special financing and free delivery. It's the Memorial Day sale, only at Steinhoffel's and Steinhoffel's.com.
To be a thriver with metastatic breast cancer means asking for what we want and need, and we need more time. So we want Kisqali. Living longer is possible and proven with Kisqali when taken with a non-steroidal aromatase inhibitor in premenopausal women with HR-positive, HER2-negative metastatic breast cancer. Kisqali is a pill that's significantly more effective at delaying disease progression versus a non-steroidal aromatase inhibitor alone. Kisqali can cause lung problems or an abnormal heartbeat, which can lead to death. It can cause serious skin reactions, liver problems, and low white blood cell counts that may result in severe infections. Tell your doctor right away if you have new or worsening symptoms, including breathing problems, cough, chest pain, a change in your heartbeat, dizziness, yellowing of the skin or eyes, dark urine, tiredness, loss of appetite, abdomen pain, bleeding, bruising, fever, chills, or other symptoms of an infection, a severe or worsening rash, are or plan to become pregnant or breastfeeding. Avoid grapefruit during treatment. Kisqali is not approved for use with tamoxifen. Ask your doctor about living longer with Kisqali.
Whether you have a design emergency or you just want to shop the best furniture showroom in town, you need Dwellings, Madison's best-kept secret for design and furniture. Shop our fabulous showroom, Hard Rock Road, Fitchburg.
And welcome back. Taking another look at our traffic right now. Everything looking pretty good to go currently, especially around the Madison area. Yesterday, we did see some slowdowns along the Beltline. Not so much actually happening here for today. So that's some good news right there. How about checking out Janesville? Much of the same. Lots of green down to our south and southeast. And then we do travel up north. Baraboo looking good to go. Lots of green on this map. And today, with the temperatures in the 80s, I would say it is a great day to get outside. Do some windows down driving.
All right, sounds good. Thank you, Austin. A 19th century bicycle famous for its giant front wheel is making a comeback.
The penny farthing was invented by the French, but made popular by the Brits. CBS's Ian Lee took the iconic bike for a spin around London.
Bit more speed, straight line.
Whoever said it's as easy as riding a bike never rode a penny farthing.
Be careful, you're riding about 7 foot up in the air.
Neil Lawton runs the Penny Farthing Club in London.
They're so unusual. These bikes had their day. Their fame was in the 1870s to 1890s.
There's a reason the term breakneck speed comes from these bikes. Back then, before gears, the bigger the tire, the faster and further you'd go. Oh, and there are no brakes.
And this is a Queen Victoria.
And its name, penny farthing, was coined from centuries-old currency.
Penny being the large coin and the farthing being the small coin. Crowd is building.
When the pandemic hit, more and more people gave these Victorian classics a spin. Bike shops saw demand double. One wheel cost you a pretty penny, though, about $2,000. But it's easy to see why there's interest. Just look at the reactions.
Nothing to see here. Just a man on a penny farthing.
To ride this beast of a bike, it's important to remember the 5 C's. Confidence, courage, commitment, coordination, concentration. And if you lose one of them, you'll learn the 6th C, crashing.
And if you fall off, you fall off.
Melissa Isdale is a penny farthing enthusiast.
Some people's perceptions might be that I might be a bit mad. But I think you have to try them to understand it. It's such good fun.
And a good way to ride around London's famous tourist attractions. Heck, you might just become one yourself.
Hello. Howdy.
Ian Lee, CBS News, London.
Penny farthing bikes can hit top speeds of over 20 miles an hour.
And no brakes.
No brakes, remember that.
We'll be right back.
McGann Furniture in downtown Baraboo should probably be called McGann Furniture and Flooring because we're the area's oldest and most experienced floor covering store. Our friendly staff will explain the many types of flooring available, answer questions, and make suggestions so you can choose what's best for your home and lifestyle. We always offer free in-home measurements and estimates and use the finest installers in the entire area. And remember, at McGann, we don't inflate prices only to mark them down for a sale. Stop in today and discover the difference. You'll be glad you did. McGann Furniture, downtown Baraboo.
3 days only. Shop the pre-Memorial Day sale at Grand Appliance for the area's lowest prices on hundreds of in-stock appliances. Plus, up to $700 in additional savings on top brands. Get great deals like this LG four-piece package with French door refrigerator and air fryer convection range for just $26.81 after rebate savings. Visit your local Grand showroom or grandappliance.com to save today. Grand Appliance, the appliance experts since 1930.
Do you suffer from ED? Did you know there could be a way to relieve ED without harmful medications, needles, or surgery? Peak Performance for Men is here to help. Click or call now to treat your ED. And remember, our results make the difference.
Are you tired of hearing it's not in stock? Madison's locally owned A1 Furniture has a huge selection of in-stock inventory available for immediate pickup or delivery. A1 has the lowest prices around. Plus, with the A1 Instant Rebate, you get $50 off of every $500 spent. This 5-piece living room set for just $9.99. Name brand mattresses in stock like this queen pillow top, just $3.99.
Shop in-store or online and save with the A1 Instant Rebate.
Only at A1 Furniture and Mattress.
Friday on News 3 Now This Morning, Chris Reese will update that weekend forecast. And we are looking at what your kids' summer camps could look like this year. Join us from 4:30 to 7 Friday for News 3 Now This Morning.
We have 2 pop-up vaccine clinics.
Come on down and get vaccinated today.
It is an important day for you parents out there.
I'll feel safer, yeah, knowing that I won't get sick.
We know that these are effective vaccines.
News 3 Now, your vaccine information headquarters.
And welcome back. Another peak here at your 7 to 10 day forecast. Lots of 80s, especially at the beginning of this forecast. Right around Wednesday of next week, we will start to cool things right back down. That's going to drop us down into the 70s, and that's a lot closer to where we should be here for this time of the year. Look at Saturday's high temperature, however, 87 degrees. Yeah, it looks like we skipped right over spring and headed directly into summer with some of those temperatures that we're looking at. Looking to stay dry on our Saturday with just a slight chance of a shower or a passing storm. Afterwards, those rain chances do return. still some sunshine here and there as well, and then that cool down for next week.
Thank you. Tomorrow on Live at 4, our canine correspondents have the top animal stories of the week.
And Michael Bruno goes behind the screens of Masquerade, a fundraiser for the Actors Fund of New York City. That's coming up tomorrow on Live at 4.
You can get personalized coupons on top of weekly sales for prices that are lower than low on food that's fresher than fresh. Pick and save. Fresh for everyone.
Right now, get $500 off stressless signature base recliners or recliners with classic power, and $200 off new motorized stressless Max and Mike recliners, the latest great innovation from Stressless. Plus, get $200 off each stressless Mary and Emily sofa seat. Celebrate 50 years of stressless comfort and save at the Century House, 3420 University Avenue in Madison.
It's that time of year to hit the open road. To make sure your trip is safe, Meineke is now offering free brake pads. Call your Madison area Meineke for details. Meineke Car Care Center is here to help.
The ups and downs of frequent mood swings can take you to deep depressive lows or give you unusually high energy even when depressed. Overwhelmed by bipolar 1? Ask about Vraylar. Some medicines only treat the lows or highs. Vraylar effectively treats depression, acute manic, and mixed episodes of bipolar 1 in adults. Full spectrum relief for all bipolar 1 symptoms with just one pill once a day. Elderly patients with dementia-related psychosis have an increased risk of death or stroke. Call your doctor about unusual changes in behavior or suicidal thoughts. Antidepressants can increase these in children and young adults. Report fever, stiff muscles, or confusion, which may mean a life-threatening reaction, or uncontrollable muscle movements, which may be permanent. Side effects may not appear for several weeks. High cholesterol and weight gain, high blood sugar, which can lead to coma or death, may occur. Movement dysfunction, sleepiness, and stomach issues are common side effects. When bipolar 1 overwhelms, Vraylar helps smooth the ups and downs.
I'm so glad you're okay, Sergeant Houston. This is Sam with USAA. Do you see the tow truck?
Yes, thank you. That was fast.
Sergeant Houston never expected this to happen, or that her grandpa's dog tags would be left behind. But that one call got her a tow and rental, paid her claim, and we even pulled a few strings, making it easy to make things right. That's what we're made for. USAA. What you're made of, we're made for. Get a quote today.
In today's Final Touch, get ready to have your mind blown.
Thanks to French contemporary artist JR, who's unveiled his latest piece. His new installation plays with the eye and gives an impression of cliffs below the Eiffel Tower. The optical illusion shows a giant Eiffel Tower in black and white, its feet standing across a precipice between two cliffs, and its top cropped to reveal the real Eiffel Tower. The illusion is viewed perfectly from a certain angle, prompting a line of visitors taking photos while jumping across the cliffs.
I can't figure this out.
JR unveiled his latest piece on the day that restaurant terraces reopened and Parisians were eager to return to a form of normalcy.
It is an illusion.